بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. My dear beloved, welcome back to Ramadan Reflections. And the month of Ramadan is the month of love. Lots of love from Allah al-Wadud subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lots of love from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم الرؤوف الرحيم الحريص على المؤمنين صلوات الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه. Lots of love from the Quran, lots of love from your guest Ramadan that's visiting you. Lots of love from everyone, and also love from me unto all of you. May Allah Ta'ala envelop us all with His love, envelop us all with His mercy, and grant us and shower us with His limitless love and forgiveness and mercies these days. Elevation spiritually, not necessarily mountain-wise. Not how many feet above sea level, but how many feet above sea level. So not the eye sight, but the heart sight that matters. Elevation in the matters of the heart, not matters of the eye. Different kind of seeing. Ramadan is all about elevation. It's that elevation that you go, and you all know when you go to a top of a mountain, you see the beauty usually of the ocean and the city in front of it. Ramadan takes you above the dunya, and you only can see the beauty. The little problems that are here and there, because you're so high up, you don't really see them. You see the bigger, beautiful picture. The beauty of Ramadan is Ramadan gives you solace with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through qiyam. When you do qiyam and the salah and the taraweeh in Ramadan, salatul layl in Ramadan, what that gives you is solace with Allah. It teaches you to have that patience to be with Allah, because we tend to run away from Allah, and Allah wants you to run to Him, not from Him. Taraweeh tells you to do, teaches you to do that, trains you to do that. So don't be too impatient. Oh, let me just do 4 rak'ah of Taraweeh today. Let me just do 6. Let me just do as much as you can if you need that training. Also, because the door of nafil is open anyway. I mean, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do nafil in Ramadan and other than Ramadan, where obviously, Al-Baqarah wa Ali Imran and Nisa in one of the narration were read all in one rak'ah. In Ramadan, there is reward in teaching you to be generous by encouraging you to give sadaqah. Not just zakatul fitr towards the end, but giving sadaqah in Ramadan, teaching you elevation. Not possession on perishable items, elevation. You rise above it. You don't have to always stick to it, because that will die. It's perishable. You can't take it with you. And if you need to fly, you've got to let go. You can't fly with your hands tight. Ramadan teaches you sadaqah and contribution. Siyam, fasting, teaches you sabr, virtue of being patient. Today, lots of the problems is we no longer appreciate the virtue of patience. People are not patient with each other. Children are not patient with each other. Parents are not patient with each other. Spouses that are newly married, they're no longer patient with each other. They want everything to be perfect from day one. They don't work with patience, and everything comes with patience. Allah yuhibbu sabirin. Allah loves people who develop this virtue of patience. Inna Allaha ma'a sabirin. Allah is with those who are patient. And then Eid comes, and Eid gives you this happiness. All right? So how can we not be happy for Ramadan? How can we not be happy for all the training that Allah Ta'ala gives us? All right? This little patience that we exercise in Ramadan yields a lot of beauty and love. May Allah Ta'ala shower you with His love and grant you all the best in Ramadan and protect you and your families. Always. الصبح بدا بدا الصبح بدا بدا الصبح بدا بدا الصبح بدا الصبح بدا بدا
الصبح بدا بدا الصبح بدا بدا الصبح بدا الصبح بدا من طلعته والليل دجى.